really want to know how much money that you need when you retire, you're going to get into some bit of mathematics. And I'm not really sure that this is the time, place, medium for us to get into mathematics. It's very important that you choose a very good financial advisor who also understands that there are various facets that will be taken into account to determine how much money you need when you retire. So the simple sort of components, and I think it's very important for you to know that these are components so you can have an intelligent conversation with your advisor, is that if you were to retire today, how much money would be sufficient for you on a month-on-month basis? There would also be certain expenditure which will come one-off, which could be a holiday, which could be some medical requirement, which could be gifts for your grandchildren, various things like that. So you need certain money for both these requirements, regular as well as irregular. The second thing is, what is going to be inflation at the time when I retire? And that's not something that you and I can judge. We are not astrologers. But what we need to keep in mind, that when you are investing in products, you try and invest in products in such a way that the return on that product is inflation adjusted positive. Which is what I mean, that if inflation is running at 6%, can I get an investment which is at least running me 7% or 8%? Now, what will happen is that if I choose only products which give me those sort of fixed rates, there is a chance that there will be some years in which inflation will suddenly jump up. At which time I need to have certain amount of money put in another bucket, which is enabling me to create capital or grow at much faster rate. So there is a little bit of risk, but the chance that it will earn 9%, 10% is sort of higher. So I need to balance the two and make sure there is enough in both these components. And of course, the biggest uncertainty that is there in terms of determining how much I need when I retire is, I don't know how long I'm going to live till. It's very important then that you look at some scientific data. One of the suggestions would be, you know, there are actuarial tables in life insurance companies which determine how long people, once they cross say 65, how many more years they're going to live, and so on and so forth. Latest Indian data I think talks about something like 20 years, 22 years if you cross 60, 62. So you're already looking at 85 if you cross the age of 60. And therefore, I think planning for how many years you're going to live is the other component. And then the favorite of at least the earlier generation, I don't know how much it's true of the current generation, is how much do I want to leave behind for my next generation? Because that's also something I want to accumulate in retirement, not spend it and say, here's my gift to you to live your life comfortably. So many of these components put together with complicated Excel sheets and tables that will allow you to determine that number, but you should be able to have that conversation with your advisor, because you know now a lot more than he does that a lot of these components are variable, they are not fixed, and doing some bit of sensitivity analysis on each one of this will allow you to figure out what I need to do in terms of my lifestyle so that my money lasts me in my retirement.